We're going to show you how to create a feasibility study document with the proposal pack wizard. Now the proposal kit system can be used for creating any kinds of documents. It's most commonly used for business proposals, quotes, business plans, but it can create any kind of Word document where you might have a front and back cover, table of contents, and a list of body pages. So because of that, you can create case studies, feasibility studies, reports, and so on. And if you look on our website, we do have an article specifically on how to write a feasibility study. And if you just scroll down that, it'll have links to a couple examples. Now, every single proposal pack and the Pro Kit will have a sample of a fully written out feasibility study that you can use as a guide. Now, when you're running the wizard, just like creating any kind of document, proposal, and so on, you just click this Document Projects button. And we're going to illustrate this with our computer's number 6 design theme. And we're going to show an example of a feasibility study for opening a new business that's IT related. So we're going to match the design theme to the type of study we're going to create. So we'll click Add New Project, and we'll click the Pick Documents button. Now this is where you can start checking off all the chapters that'll make up your study, and you'll see the 40 most common templates usually used, and this is mostly related to proposals, since that's the most common thing done. But you'll probably start with a title page, table of contents, back page, and then you'll pick body pages based on the type of study. Now you actually have thousands of chapters to pick from, and while you only see the 40 most common right here, you can get to those thousands of other pages through categories you can select from this drop-down. Or if you have a specific chapter you want to look for by name, you can just type it here. Say you need a budget template, some financial templates. You just search for whatever you're looking for. Just search for single words, like say if you want a mission statement, search for the word mission. Now if you want to see the example of the pre-written feasibility study, you just go over to the View Samples tab. There's hundreds of samples. You can either do a search by the word feasibility or just scroll down the list and you'll see the feasibility study sample. Now these samples are PDFs. You know, we can open the sample and look at it. And the samples will be illustrated with, you know, a specific design theme, not necessarily the design theme you purchased, but when you create your own version of any of these samples, you can recreate the sample with the same content, the same text of the sample, but it'll all be pulled into your design theme and as an editable Word document. Now the odds of you actually being in the same exact situation as a sample and can use the whole thing as is are pretty slim, but the samples are meant to get you an idea of how you can create something. Now we can go over to this Quick Start tab, and there's hundreds and hundreds of more layouts than there are in the samples. And anything that's in the sample list will be in the Quick Start list. And the Quick Start list may actually have additional chapter templates added to them to give you more writing ideas. So we can just do a search on the word feasibility. And you can shorten up your search terms just to make it a little easier. And there's actually a few feasibility template layouts. And when you click any layout, it'll tell you the actual list of chapters that are going to get imported out of the library of thousands of available templates. You know, this one has 16 selected. We're just going to import this. And if any of these quick start lists are related to the samples, it'll give you the option of pulling in the sample content as well. Okay, now we have 16 chapters selected for this feasibility study. Now you can completely customize this list of chapters. You can drop out any chapters you don't want. You have thousands of additional chapters you can pick from to add to this layout. using these add templates, search by name, tabs, and so on. So once we've selected all of our chapters, got the order the way we want it, we just click the OK select a templates button, we're back on the project screen, and you can fill in, say, the company data screen with your name and address information, which will get merged into the document. The client data probably isn't going to be as useful for a feasibility study unless you're writing the study to another specific person. If you fill this in, that will merge their name and address into, say, the front cover or cover letter if you selected that. And when we're all done setting up our project, and you also notice this dropdown has been set to study. So this is how you can change the major word on the front title page. Normally it's going to say proposal, but we're going to change it to the study. And you have lots of options of different graphics titles to pick from here. Now when we click the OK Save Project button, this is when the wizard is going to take all of our customizations, the design theme, imported content, any graphics changes, color changes, font changes, and it applies all of that to the document it's generating. Now we just sit back and wait for the wizard to finish building this document. Okay, this document has been created. Let's take a look at it. And you can see our computer's number 6 design theme, you know, these background graphics and logo and so on. It's merged in the information we put on the company data screen. Now for studies, you know, you might not be doing a prepared for, prepared by, like a proposal, so you could just reword this text however you want. You know, maybe put in some introduction, few sentences or paragraph. And as we scroll down, we see the table of contents, the list of chapter pages for this feasibility study. Now this feasibility here, this is a chapter within the overall feasibility study document. And things like this proposal kit, this is going to be your information you merge in, not ours. So everything will be branded actually to you. You know, you won't see our name on the front of any of these pages. And this is the list of chapters that have all been assembled for this feasibility study. You know, tables. Now, if you're using the professional version, you can actually have these financial tables directly linked to Excel spreadsheets. So you could do your cost-benefit analysis within a spreadsheet. I can show this here. So in the basic version, or if you have this feature turned off, you know, you do have these calculator spreadsheets we've created for any financial related pages. And if you turn on the dynamic spreadsheet linking feature, these cells of these tables will actually be directly linked to the cells in the spreadsheet. So as you do your calculations in the spreadsheets, it will auto-update into the Word document. So we're turning this feature off in this demo just for demo purposes, but that is available in the Professional Edition. And you can see company data merged in here. This will be your name, address, contact information when you fill in the company data screen. Now we'll illustrate a second feasibility study for a completely different situation. And we're going to illustrate this with a different design theme. Now, you'll note we have hundreds and hundreds of design themes, but only the one or ones you've purchased you'll have access to in this drop-down list. We just happen to have all of our styles here for demo purposes. And we're going to illustrate this with a more general purpose design theme, our classic number 21. And we're going to illustrate a feasibility for a business startup. And just like before, whenever we're going to create a document, click the Document Projects button, we'll add a new project, go to the Pick Documents screen, and we're going to import another feasibility study layout we've already pre-created in the Quick Start list. You know, I can either do a search on the word feasibility, or I can scroll down alphabetical order through all the layouts. And I'm going to pick this feasibility study for business startup. And you'll see again, it starts with the title page, table of contents, same as before, back page. But now the interior pages are different for this feasibility study. And you can pick chapters that are related to specific industries if you need to tailor this to something, say, medical or construction, real estate, you know, environmental, doesn't matter. You've got access to thousands of templates to customize this list of chapters with. And you'll do that through these add templates, search by name tabs. So you can see after we've imported that list, you'll see a few of these checked off in the screen. And if we needed to add chapters for specific industries or situations, we can scroll down, we can look at list of chapters for all sorts of different things. And we can use the search by name if we need to say a mission statement, a particular financial topic, some data information, any word you can think of we might have a chapter for, just search for that here. And that is how you customize and build up your list of chapters. Okay, now that we're done selecting our chapters for this feasibility study, click the OK button. Now we're back on the project screen. And you'll see we have it set to study again as our main title page graphic. And like the company data and client data screens again, this is going to be your information you type in. And this is what gets merged into the front back covers and so on. You know, client data, we're leaving this blank for now. But if you filled this in, this would be merged into like the front cover, for example. Now when we're all done, again, we click the OK Save Project button, sit back and wait for the wizard to assemble the document. All right, now this feasibility study document has been generated. Take a look at this. And you can see now the design theme is different. This is the classic 21 design. Could be a good general purpose business design because it kind of invokes that idea of business growth or movement in the design of the logo and the background graphics. And again, you can swap out these graphics background pictures with your own. And there's a table of contents, and you can see it's got a different set of interior pages. Now, this type of feasibility study might be a precursor to doing a full business plan, and you could actually convert this feasibility study into a business plan by just adding some additional chapters to it to flesh out the business plan version of this. And you can see the chapters ready to fill in. Operating costs. Now, again, just like we had a different financial topic in the previous feasibility study example, you know, this document uses two financial related templates, operating costs and income projection. Now, there are a lot more financial topics you can pick from in the proposal pack when you're generating documents, and any one of them that has a table with numbers is going to have an associated Excel spreadsheet. We can open up the income projection calculator. It's been copied into our project, and it'll actually fill these in with the current year and out a couple more years in this case. It's got some default line items, so you know, these are just up to you to now start filling in line items and totals. In the basic version, just like I mentioned before, this is just going to be an independent Excel spreadsheet for you to do some calculations in, and then you would type in the totals into the Word document for the presentation version. Using the Pro Kit, the Proposal Kit Professional, you could turn on the dynamic linking feature and actually link these cells directly to the table cells, and doing your calculations in Excel will auto update the Word document. So that is available again in the Professional Edition. And we just scroll down to the end of this example. And that is all there is to creating a feasibility study document in the Proposal Kit. You just select a specific design theme, select a set of chapters to match, and generate a document. And then you have a template ready to fill in. Let us know what you think in the comments below. And click subscribe to keep up on the latest proposal writing tips with Proposal Kit.